Hi everyone, this is Dave and welcome to a new video on the Geekanoids channel. In today's video we're going to be taking a look at this tiny little camera inside this black box here. This is the Fujifilm X70. Now this could be the ideal camera for street photography. It's got a fixed focal length of 28mm, no zooming in and out, you have to use your legs to do the zooming, and we're going to be taking a look inside the box very shortly. Also going through the specifications and the features and having a look at some of the photographic results. Okay, so let's take a look inside the Fuji X70 box. And it's very minimal packaging. I really do like the way that Fuji pack all of their cameras. Now this is a 16.3 million pixel camera, APS-C size sensor, a fixed focal length lens, 28mm. So you're going to have to use your feet to do the zooming. Really nicely packaged. The first thing we got is a warranty booklet. We've also got a manual on CD. And we've also got a printed owner's manual as well. And then inside, this is how it's presented inside the box. We've got an accessory section on the front here and the camera in the back. So let's take a look at the accessories first. So we've got a micro USB to full-size USB cable. We've also got a little adapter for the charging. This is a 2-pin Euro adapter. We've also got the one that I'll be using, which is a 3-pin UK adapter. And then we've got tiny little USB multi-voltage charger. So your adapter goes on the front here, or you could use a longer cable if you needed to, but it's meant for those little adapter plates. And then the USB to micro USB cable goes on this end. You charge the battery in situ inside the camera. We've got some little split rings for attaching a strap and some little protectors as well that protect the camera. Then we've also got the battery. So the model number of this battery is the NP95, and this is an 1800 milliamp hour battery. So quite a high capacity for quite a compact little unit. So hopefully that will last reasonable amount of time. And then we've got a Fuji branded camera strap as well. And then we move on to the actual camera. So this is available in all black or black and silver. This particular one's the black and silver, which looks a little bit more retro. And this came from Park Cameras. Big thank you must go out to them. I'll leave a link to their website in the video description. I get pretty much all of my photography gear there, and they've just got a fantastic service. So this is the Fuji X70. Let's take a look around. So we've got the lens cap on the front here, and this reveals the 28mm. It's an f2.8 lens, and this is a fixed lens, so there's no zoom in. So if you want to zoom in and out or get in with the action, you actually have to walk closer to your subject. So that's going to be quite challenging for me. I'm used to having the flexibility of a zoom lens. We've got a aperture ring on the back, and you can actually rotate this round. If you see at the moment, we've got this in the A position, and whilst it's in the A position, it's actually in automatic. So if we want aperture priority, we simply move it round to our desired aperture. And then we've got a very slimline focus ring here as well. And whilst I've got the camera in this position, I'll show you the top panel. So we've got stereo microphones that accompany the 1080p 60 frame per second video that it's capable of. And we've also got hot shoe. We've got the shutter dial here, and again this acts the same as the aperture ring. So when it's in the A portion, it's automatically selecting the shutter speed. If we take it out of the A position, then we've got it in a manual shutter speed. So if we have the aperture ring in A and this on a particular shutter speed, we're shooting in shutter priority. If we have both of the dials set to A, then we're in fully automatic. But if you do want to quickly change to automatic, you have got an actual switch. So this puts the camera into fully automatic mode. We've got the on-off toggle here. We've also got the shutter button, direct recall button, which is quite awkwardly placed. We've got exposure compensation dial here and a drive button just here. We go back around to the front of the camera. We've got the mode here as well. So we've got continuous, single and manual. So that's really good. This is like the, not the drive, this is the focus
So single focus, continuous focus, or manual focus on an actual dedicated switch. Little tiny flash here, nice grip area just here, little eyelets for connecting a camera strap or a wrist strap. We go around onto this side, we can open up this, and this reveals the remote in, which is a 2.5mm socket, but you can also use this for a microphone. We've also got the sort of multi-AV cable out, and then a micro USB connector for charging the battery. If we look around on this side, we've got another function button just on this side here, which is really nice. This can be reprogrammed to what you want it to do. On the bottom here, we've got a tiny little speaker. We've also got the tripod mount, which is metal. And then we've got the flap here that opens, which is where you're going to put the battery and also your memory card. This is an SD card, SDHC or SDXC. Round onto the back. And this is one of the first Fuji cameras that's actually got a touchscreen. This is a 3-inch, 1.04 million dot touchscreen. That's really nice to see. And this also articulates as well. I'll show you that in a short while. Trash can for deleting, playback button at the top, little toggle dial just here, which also acts as a button for making selections, little thumb grip, LED light, AEL and AFL here as well, maybe for exposure lock. We've also got quick menu button, four-way buttons here, menu and OK display, and another function button just here. I mentioned to you the screen actually is articulating. It doesn't flip out this way. It actually allows you to angle it down at this angle for doing sort of over the head shots. You can of course angle it up for doing low angle shots, and it does actually go all the way around, so you can actually use it in a selfie mode, and this is ideal for if you're recording videos of yourself. So anyway, that's a look around the camera. I'm really impressed with how this feels. It's a very nicely constructed camera, a very good price point as well for the Fuji X70, a nice large APS-C size sensor with 16 megapixels, and I'm going to be using this primarily for street photography, and I'll show you some of the results in this very video.
So I've been using the Fuji X70 for quite a while now, and I've been really enjoying it for a number of reasons. There are a few negatives, but I'll cover those off in a short while. First of all, let's talk about the menu system and the screen. The menu system is very well laid out indeed. You've got so many different options and everything is really customizable. It's really well laid out as well. I like Fuji's menu system. I think they've done a fantastic job. The one downside is that although this is the first Fuji camera to implement a touchscreen, they didn't implement the touch access to the menus, which is a shame. The touch sensitive nature of the screen really only comes into play when you're in live view, and you can use it to touch to move your focus point, and then you use the shutter button in the normal way to take the photo, or indeed you can use the touch screen to touch and actuate the shutter. And it works very well. I just wish they'd really pushed the boundaries and given us a nice touch-friendly menu to use. The screen is lovely though. We've got no viewfinder on here at all, so you're reliant on the screen for framing your photos. I like the way that you can actually tilt it up, you can also tilt it down, and you can tilt it all the way to actually face forwards. And this is ideal for if you're taking a selfie or a group shot where you want to check that the framing's correct, or indeed if you're using this for vlogging and you're capturing video. Now, I'm not going to show you any video captured with this. I'm going to save that for a separate video, but the 1080p video is pretty good. It's one of the better sort of video performances from a Fuji camera to date. The focus isn't stellar, but it's acceptable. But as I say, I like the fact you can flip that screen up. You've also got the microphone input as well, so it could be perfect for many vloggers. But we're going to talk about the photographs that this produces, and I really have enjoyed my time taking photographs with this on the street. It is perfectly suited for it. We've got that 28mm focal length range, and you can't zoom in or out. That's one of the things you have to get your head around with the X70. If you want to frame something with your subject really dominant in the scene, you have to get closer. You have to use your legs and walk closer to the subject matter. And the same applies if you want a more wider, expansive view, you have to walk further away. And it makes you think about the composition of your photos a great deal. I also really like the film simulations in here. You've got the option of shooting raw, which remain untouched, but the actual JPEGs that are processed using these film sort of simulations are amazing. The colors that a Fuji camera actually captures and produces in the JPEGs is like no other, and I really do like the way they're rendered. I also like some of the black and white film simulations as well, and when the scene is right for that black and white photo, the contrast, the amount of detail and the depth that we get from the Fuji X70 is absolutely fantastic. You can also use bracketing on here, not only exposure bracketing but also film simulation bracketing as well, so you could have three different film simulations on a JPEG and an untouched RAW from the camera. Everything feels really very, very nice. It's a tiny bit cramped on the back if I was sort of really trying to pick some faults, and also the aperture ring, you're relying on these two tabs to actually get hold of it, so that's a little bit difficult. And of course the focus ring is very, very thin. With the hood on, that makes it even more difficult to use the manual focus. But if they'd made things any bigger, it wouldn't have been as compact as it is. So I think they made the right sort of design choice for the X70. I think overall, it's a very well balanced camera and it produces excellent photos. So that's it for this video. If you're looking for a decent camera that is going to be perfect for street photography, then I really highly recommend the Fujifilm X70. Let me know what you thought of the photos that you saw during this video as well. Leave me some comments, hit that like button, and I'll see you in another video very soon.